I'm the first one to speak English today, and my name is Valeria, and I am a representative of the IIBA Latvia chapter, and I am pleased to open this evening, and I hope you enjoy it. As Gundega mentioned at the beginning, for those who don't know what is IIBA Latvia chapter mean, so this is the non-profit professional organization for the system and business analysts here in Latvia, and this Latvian organization has the status of IIBA chapter, which is the IIBA, the International Institute of Business Analysis, which is based in Canada, and it's a huge business analyst non-profit organization. And IIBA mostly is famous for their right to the business analysis body of knowledge, which is Bible, or for us, for business system analysts, is some kind of Bible. And this book includes all the descriptions of all activities business analysts or system analysts perform. And the other important is the competency model, which allows us to assess the business and system analysts, and the, of course, the first recognized certification for business and system analysts, which is CCBA and CBA. Why I am here? First week, as I said, yes, and I am IT person, and I am devoting myself to the business analysis, system analysis field already for 4 years, and I'm expecting as well to develop myself in future. And as well, I'm a co-founder and board member of already mentioned IIBA. My scope for today is to talk about the requirements lifecycle in a plan-driven approach, and so to talk about to. By the plan-driven approach, we mean this very formal and structured software development approach. And the most common and argued model, of course, is the waterfall model, but there are other models like incremental V models and spiral models. And the most famous frameworks are the IBM Group and MSF. And what common things in this methodology or approach, these methodologies and frameworks, is that the analysis is done and requirements are defined and specified in the early beginning before the development and designing or testing. This is the common thing. And but if you look on the scope of the analysis defined by the Bailey book, that the analyst shall perform like six group of activities in order to, from need, problem, or opportunity, to gain the added value and to design the solution. But today we will focus on three of these activity groups, which are requirements, solicitations, analysis, and requirements, management, and communication. So firstly, if we're talking about requirements, so this is a condition or capability that must be met in the provided solution in order to satisfy the stakeholders. And requirements has its own, and requirements supposed to be complete, clean, correct, and consistent. In plan-driven approach, there are different, recognized different types of requirements, as well as business rules, constraints, and assumptions, and stakeholders. And as well, during the analysis, requirements change their states, and there are a lot of different states. We will talk about it a bit later. So the first activity, which is requirements elicitation, and for me the most exciting one, because we are meeting the client, the stakeholder, and the purpose of this activity is to understand the needs of the stakeholder, and we are, as different elicitation techniques, and the most popular ones are, of course, interviews, most interesting observations, then we have survey questionnaires, different kind of workshops, brainstorming, as well as document analysis, like reading the existing procedures, existing specification or legislation. And as we all know, that the beginning of the analysis phase for the analyst will look like this. We have, in case you have a lot of stakeholders, so we have a lot of work. The second activity group after elicitation is the requirement analysis, where we are defining the requirements for the potential solutions in order to satisfy those needs and define the stakeholders' requirements. And the very important thing in this plan-driven approach and in this approach, that in the requirement analysis stage, there are very commonly not only requirements of the solutions are defined, but also the current state of the enterprise of the problem domain, and this current state helps the developers as well as the stakeholders to identify things need to be maintained or changed in the future, and the opportunities for improvement of the problem domain. And we use as well a list of different techniques. I list a lot of them, but I'm not mentioning all of them. Maybe in future this presentation can serve you in order to do some techniques. And the most popular and commonly used analysis techniques are modeling, spread modeling, process modeling, modeling this systems to be systems, decomposition, and user stories, and other a different kind of diagrams, which can help you to understand what shall be done. And, so this is just different examples from different projects. Each project is very different, and these use techniques and use models and notations vary in every project. So this is one of my favorite as well techniques is prototyping, which is in my opinion very good for the stakeholders that are not so IT educated, and it's more easier to read the specification in prototypes. And the last one, but as well very important, is the requirements management and communication, where the purpose is to ensure that everybody involved in the project shared understanding about the solution which will be developed in the further steps. And the main idea is to prepare the requirements package, which is usually our system requirements specification, and to communicate the system. And these techniques used that for management, usually it's a formal documentation, I mentioned system requirement specification, or it can be as well presentation or models, it's how you negotiate with your stakeholder. And for the communication, usually structured walkthroughs are used for requirements workshops and presentations as well. So this is the example of the specifications and the main idea to show that these specifications as well apply. And as analysts, we're trying to use a very different ways in describing and specifying requirements, tables, diagrams, rich pictures, in order so this shared understanding be achieved. And the change management in the plan-driven approach is the main idea, and as think that it's very nice for the agile way, that the changes are like in a plan-driven approach is like a mini project, and its changes usually occur at the end of the project in the testing phases, and there is a very formal way on processing those changes. You need to response to all formal procedures. And it's as well as in case of the complex problem domain, and you have a lot of stakeholders, a lot of people involved, it is very difficult to gather all information, and usually one individual, different individuals talks differently about the same thing, even in this problem domain. So it's challenging for analysts to understand the topic. And in case of limited access to subject matter experts, it is challenging as well. We need more, maybe to make this document analysis and more to read those legislation documents. You need a lot to learn in mostly in a very short period of time in order to understand this problem domain. And because you're becoming this subject matter expert, people rely on you with this huge responsibility. You need to make a lot of decisions on your own. And of course, you need your typing a lot. But there are, of course, benefits, and those benefits are bigger than the challenges. And the main thing that the plan-driven approach while becoming the subject matter expert by gaining the new business model, which serves me not only in the professional field but as well in my day-to-day life. And then I'm gaining the professional skills as well, because every project can bring the different tools, different methodology. Gaining those this knowledge as well, and the other thing that based on this business knowledge, if I understand okay this business, then I can bring new ideas to my enterprise about this, what can be improved, and what, for example, new IT solutions can be introduced. Of course, I'm gaining the valuable contacts and as well the respect and trust of the other subject matter experts, because they see if I can learn these things in a short period of time, they are very respected.
Well, any questions?
I have a question. Can you explain why exactly the last two slides, how exactly they apply to this waterfall or whatever plan-driven approach?
Rules?
Yeah, challenges and the limited access to SME, what to learn, responsibility, decision-making, how is that applicable to?
This is from my experience being in the, I have no experience in the JAL project, and while being in those plan-driven projects, this is the things that I'm challenging.
Okay, so they might be challenges in any project, you just think that they were more applicable.
But I'm talking about the plan-driven approaches, in case the change-driven approach presentation will have challenges and they will be the same, that's okay.
Okay.
It's just for plan-driven approach, probably.
There was shown that they are using unified process from rational in plan-driven. How?
Rational unified process within an IBM framework, preparing the documents, verifying the templates,
and the specifications also.
Formal documentation. Mm-hmm. And that analyst is not working only in this analysis phase, but as well in the other phases to support this concept.
Can you tell what tools are you using for prototyping of the interface?
The last one was, it's not actually just, it's not like prototyping, not prototyping, but this Balsamic tool. Then I used, don't remember the name, Visio, of course. Balsamic Visio, and the other one, I don't remember, I can add the presentation. This one was very good because it allowed to make those applications without Visio, but in new project we use this Balsamiq as well.
Could you tell him in one sentence what is requirement?
Or requirements?
No, just what is a requirement? What is this thing?
Requirement is capability or possibility that shall be met in the any solution.
The meaning shall, so what means shall?
Shall means
company.
By wish of God or by some other forces or
if you're talking about the God, you're from the AGM team, I guess. By shall I mean that the solution shall I mean developed.
Why it should be met?
Because it brings the value, and it brings the value, and it solves the problem.
Why should how do we know?
Because you're starting with defining the problem, or the
design. How do we know that this requirement will solve the problem?
You trace that. You define the requirement, and then you trace it to ensure so
at the end,
stakeholders
I will know that,
that it's resolve this problem.
So if it will not solve the problem, so then it was not requirement or what?
It was requirement.
No, if at the end we find out that it didn't solve the problem, so then it wasn't requirement or still was requirement?
It was unprecise mistake requirement.
So if we, the more we state precisely the but if we say it in 100 pages and it still didn't solve the problem, so is it still a requirement?
Why pages were mentioned?
What you mean if it was not precisely stated?
That probably the stakeholder need was not well understood.
So if we understood, so we understood really well, so we still didn't solve the problem. So then it still was requirement or not?
In the analysis phase. So if we stated a lot of requirements.
No, so I'm trying to understand what is requirement.
I guess we will discuss this thing in the end of our event, okay? Short of time for every track, so let's talk about in the end.
The basic definition for
now, so one sentence definition of requirement.
Requirement acceptance of the requirement.
This one. What means must? So will I be killed if I didn't if it will be
Yep. You will not get the money. You won't be killed. You will not
so
get
is it
the money.
Then regarding money or that?
It's some kind of kidnapping. If you are kidnapped, you got requirements to get free. You fail, you lose. Whatever it takes.
Okay, let's postpone discussion.
Okay.
Valeria, you talk about that during your analysis phase, you gain a lot of knowledge in the, some kind of problem area, or a business process or something like that. By the way, what do you think, can the business analyst suggest a kind of change in terms of your presentation change? For the current project, for the any kind of process. And did you?
I have suggested some changes.
And they were successfully approved. So you bring in your position, you can bring a business value to your company.
Of course, not only for my company.
Okay, thanks.